Hey everyone, it's Amanda and Monicarloomy, and we are here with our newest tutorial with our bracelet that we have called Western Lace. This is the one that we showed everyone on Instagram, and here is one that we made that anyone can make without using beads. So we wanted to show that it can be done, and it does not have to use any beads if you do not want it to be used with beads. And this can also be done on one loom. So in this tutorial, we are going to go over and do the bracelet all in one full or two full lengths. We're going to do it all at one time. And then after we have the completed bracelet on the six pin bars, then we will go back and we will do the tutorial for the one loom design, which is the same, you just have to transfer. So go get your bands and your hook and a C-clip and come right back. So first off, I wanted to go over how the loom needs to be set up. You need to have one pin bar a little up from the second pin bar, and then you need to have four pin bars all even, and then the last pin bar needs to be up half bunch. So that's how your loom, if you're doing it on the six pin bar setup, and we're gonna do it on the two loom links to make a whole bracelet, because we don't like extensions. And for this tutorial, we are not gonna be doing the brown color. We just thought that was kind of cute to do the brown for our Western theme. We're going to do kind of a, since it's getting cold where we are and it's supposed to snow this weekend, we are going to do a basically a snow-like themed one. And we are going to be using these beads, which are like a light blue, kind of periwinkle color. We will be using a medieval navy silicone band, a sweet navy silicone. We'll be using a silver silicone, and we'll be using the white or iridescent glitter silicone band. And then we will use the White Frost Limited Edition bands. And you will not be able to see them, but we are also going to be using regular jelly clear bands. All of these bands can be purchased off of rainbowloom.com. And let's get started. All right, so before we get started, I wanted to tell everyone that it really depends on what bands you use when you are trying to determine the length of the bracelet that you want. Here are the two bracelets that I made for the demo, and one is just slightly longer. This one's a little bit longer, the one that I use the bands on. And I use the same techniques on this one that I did with the beads. So it depends with the bands and the beads, or the bands that you're going to use in place of the beads. What all you use, it all depends. I would say if you're not using, on this one, I used all silicone bands in the middle. I would say if you're not going to use the silicone bands in the middle, if you're not going to use those, that you should go down at least four or five of the pins and stop there for your bracelet. If you're going to use the original Rainbow Loom colors, all the opaques or the jellies, I would stop right around here for an average wrist size. So let's get started. And like I said, we are going to do a new color scheme. And we are going to be using this medieval navy. the Sweets Navy, the Iridescent or White Glitter Silicone. Oh, and those two, the Medieval and the Sweets, both navies, were both the 300 count all silicone. The Silver Silicone and the Limited Edition White Frost. And I will show you where all of these are in this bracelet versus in the different colors that we're using on this bracelet. And we're using one more color or one more type of band, but you will not see it. It will be covered up. You can't see it on this one. It is just a clear jelly glitter, glitter. I can't talk tonight. All right, it's just a clear jelly band. I got it. Okay, so, and it is used for some extra work that we have to do to make it a little more squishy, I guess. Squishy? I like squishy. All right, so what we are going to do is right now we are going to be doing... What is wrong with me tonight? I cannot talk, guys. Help me out here, man. All right, so what we're going to do is first, we are just going to do two full-length rows of a single chain of all of the jelly clears. And it's just one band going up both lengths of the loom. If you're doing all the way up the length of the loom, if you're not, you need to stop at where you think that the average length of your wrist would go. Around here, you would stop for an average length while you're using the opaque bands. But this one, I went all the way up the length of the loom, and this was this fit Amanda. But this was using the silicone bands. So I'm gonna go all the way up the length of the loom. And as I said before, these are just in the inside, and you will find out in a little bit where they go after we place all of our bands. So I'm gonna do one of these. I'm just gonna keep this on camera since it's so fast. All the way up the length of the loom, and you're going to need to make two of these. I'm just going to make one on camera, but you're going to need to make two of these for both sides of the bracelet. And this is another reason that it's able to be done on one loom and then transferred. All right, so I'm going to turn it around. And I'm going to triple cap it. One, two, three. And I'm just going to easy peasy, eggs and cheesy, going to loop it all up. I know you all can't see this very well on there, but it's just a single chain that's going up the length of the loom. And these are going to be taken off before we start the actual bracelet. And I will show you. You need to have like a holding hook or just a holding stick. I know I have some, what are they called? Like kebab sticks, like pieces of wood. Sometimes that I use to hold my stuff on, like when I'm making a figurine or something with arms and legs to hold on those extra pieces. So I am just going to take this off and you need to make two of these, okay? So I'll be right back. I'm going to make my other one. I'm going to come back and we're going to start the actual part of the bracelet. All right, so I went ahead and made both of the single chains and the jelly clear. And now I'm going to go ahead and start the bracelet. I am using the silicone band, so I'm going to go the full length. But I will show you where you should stop If you want to do a one in the opaque or jelly bands or the new 600 bands that have come out for an average size wrist. Now, since we're using different colors, I'll tell you where each one of these are in the mock-up bracelet that I made. But right now, we are going to be using two bands, two of the silicone sweets navy. I think this is like one of my favorite ones. Now they have the white. Hold on. The new white ones. Oh my goodness. I love them, but we're not using those. Sorry, I just had those because I was working on something. I think those are like my new favorite. So we're gonna put two of the sweets silicone navies on the third and the fourth pin bar. This is the only time until you're getting ready to put a cap band at the other end that you're gonna use two bands on two pins. Now you're gonna have one band of the sweets navy from the second to the third, and another one from the fourth to the fifth. That's all we're gonna use of the sweets navy right now, and I'm gonna explain when we get to where the rest of the sweets navy goes, where it is on this bracelet, so you're not confused, because I don't want you to be confused, because this is just, it needs to be on the bottom when we loom it back, and I want you all to know when we're putting it on the actual portion throughout the bracelet where it should go. All right, now we're getting ready to use our limited edition white frost. And on this bracelet, it was the limited edition gold, like glittery gold, the new one. And I really love it. Here it is on the back. And this is kind of a reversible bracelet, I guess you could use it as, but I really love the front of it. So, and it's supposed to be worn this way. But this is where the white frost will be going, where the gold limited edition is on this one. So on our loom, we're gonna make triangles. We've done this on other tutorials and different bracelets. We're just gonna do triangles all the way up the bracelet on both sides. And you're gonna connect them with that one pin on the inside bar. You're gonna go all the way up, and I will stop and show you where, when we come back, where if you're using regular bands, where you could stop. I'll be right back. So here is where I left off, where I feel like if you would be making this with opaque or jelly original rainbow loom bands or the new 600 count sweets and medieval and pearls, you could stop right here. But I'm going to continue going, or possibly even on the fourth one. It's kind of a trial and error thing. But I'm going to keep going since I'm using the 300 count silicone and the other silicone bands that can be a little tight. And even these limited edition bands can be tight too. So I just finished out doing that. Now, I know this is going to seem kind of odd because it's going to be like white on white, but it will come out totally different. But I'm getting ready to put the iridescent or white glitter silicone bands on. And on this bracelet, it is where I used the Mother of Pearl 600 counts, which is another favorite of Amanda and mine's. And here it is on the back, and we're going to be using a technique that was used on the Swan bracelet. That's another reason I'm wearing this. So I will go ahead and place them, but I wanted to show you how they looked on this bracelet with the Mother of Pearls. Here it is on the side. I really love the side profile of this too. It looks very stitched up. All right. So what we're going to do is we're going to go and we're going to do... As it pops off, how many of you all have like found so many bands on your floor after you've like been vacuuming and stuff? You're like, oh my goodness. So you're just doing a zigzag in between all of these triangles at both sides. I'm literally doing a zigzag. All right, I'm gonna start over here. And the reason I chose to do the glitter here is because it's not actually going to be right on top of that white frost. It's going to be on the sides, and we're going to have this gorgeous navy sweets in between that. So it's going to really pop out. All right, I'm going to do one more, and I'm going to go off camera. I'm going to finish the rest of the loom, and I will be right back. So I've gone all the way up here to the end. Wherever you stop at is where you're going to put your last band of the zigzag. And now we are ready to start on our next band. I'm just going to kind of push some of these down because you are going to be having bands on all of these pegs. Probably should have done that before I started the video back up, but you know, that's how we roll. You all just get the joy of watching me push them all down. You know you like it. You know you like watching them all being pushed down. Alright, so now is where we get to go back and we get to use our sweet navy blue. I just love the sweet navy blue. All right, and that is where on the sides where I've used Tin Man, this brown color right here, you can see it on the sides, that's where the sweet navy blue is going to be on this bracelet. It's gonna be all along this border. All right, so, and these are all single bands once again, and you're gonna start down here from where you stopped with the blue right here. You're gonna start it up and just make a single chain going all the way down. Let me start over here. Start going up. I'm going to continue doing this and I will be right back and I will show you how to do it at the end, because you're not going to close it off here at the end just yet. So I'll be right back. So I have gone down the entire length of the loom with a single chain and I have stopped right here. You're going to go in once and that's all you're going in for right now. We're going to put the rest of the bands on at the very end after we have put the middle bands and the beads on, and I will show you how to do that after I have all those on. So now we're going to be using two different types of bands for the middle, and that is going to be these colors right here in the middle, and on this one you can see it's the same way. On this, I used the Egyptian brown and the sweets brown. I did the same on this one. And we're going to do the same pattern on this bracelet that we're making now, which I have a sweets brown, then an Egyptian brown. A sweets brown and an Egyptian brown. So that's what we're going to do with these colors. And I'm going to be using the medieval navy. And I'm going to be using the silicone silver. So it doesn't matter which one you start with, it's whichever one you prefer. And as Amanda would say, she loves doing this. I don't know why, I just don't know why. But anyways, what you're gonna do is you're gonna be making your X's. You can start from whichever side. Everyone knows I'm a lefty, so I always start from the left. And you can change up the pattern, but I'm gonna stick with this pattern. I have two of the medieval navy blues, and then I have the silicone silver. And I'm just going to be going back and forth up the whole loom doing this. I'm going to do it one more time, but I'm sure everyone knows how to do this. This is an original rainbow loom design bracelet idea concept. The X's are way long ago. So we have modified it, and a lot of people use it in their bracelets now. Alrighty. So just continue all the way up your bracelet to the very end, whichever place you have stopped at the end of the loom, and I will be right back. So here are the X's. I have gone all the way up here to the top. Remember, wherever you stopped for your bracelet is where you will stop with your X's. Now is the part where I'm going to show you how to do the beads. And here are the beads that I'm using for this bracelet. I'm going to show you how to do beads, and I'm going to also show you how to do just bands on there. And this is where you're still going to be using these clear jellies. And if you right now we're going to be doing the beads, and I have my wire, and let me see. Here is the wire that I'll be using. I've got it from Michaels. I think it was Michaels. Michaels. And so what you're going to do for the beads is you're going to put, I've made my wire into a V. You're going to put it on one side. And then you're going to take the two ends of the wire and you're going to put the bead. You're going to find the hole in the bead and you're going to put the two pieces of the wire through the bead. You're going to pull it through. I'm going to make a couple more of these. Good. I'm only pulling the band halfway through, because you're going to be putting it on quite a few pegs, and if you want the bead to stay on the band, you only pull it halfway through. All right, so I'm going to put these away, and now I'm going to show you how to do it with just a band. If you don't have beads, some of us just don't like the look of beads. Some of us like the look of just bands. So I'm going to show you how to do it with just the bands. So you need your trusty hook, or if you do it feeling spiffy's way or crafting fantastic's way, you can use the slip knot hook that she's talked about in her happy fruits or happy foods videos. So what you're going to do is you're going to wrap the band around three times. Hold on, one, two, three. And you're going to add one more band to it. One, two, three. Oops, lost the last one. So you have two bands on here right now. Then you're going to pick up your clear jelly band and pull all of them through. So now what you would do is, at this point, I would put this on the loom. I would hold it with my fingers because the bands are not holding on to the bands that are looped around three times will fall off if you let go of the jelly band. So I would, at this point, I would put it on to the place wherever I wanted it on my loom, but I'm not going to be using this one for this tutorial. I'm going to be using the beads. So here is what, if you use just bands, it would look like, and that would be really pretty in the middle too, since you use these on the outside, it would kind of bring it all in together. So I'm going to get out my beads, and since these beads are kind of wide, I'm only going to be doing it every other time here in the middle. And If you have smaller beads, like little 6 millimeter beads, those you can do every single time. But like with these butterfly beads, I did these every other time. And if I had done them every time, they would not be laying flat. They would be all up on each other and getting in each other's space and arguing and everything. So we don't want that. We are going to do it every other time. But if you have smaller beads that would fit, you can do them every time. So what I'm going to do, it usually helps me out, is if I put the bands in the places where there's not going to be any beads first, so I know where to just place my beads. So I already have it all mapped out. Down here on this first one, you don't need to put any bands. The second one's going to be a bead. Now this third one's where we're going to put our first band. And you're gonna put it across all four of these pins. It needs to go all across them. It can't be up here. It has to be all across them because you're gonna have to loop through that. Then I'm gonna skip one. So for some reason, my video cut out when I was placing the bands, the clear bands over the four pegs, but I have gone ahead and they are on every other four pegs all the way here to the end. And here on the end, this is the last one I'm placing, because down here you're gonna use the sweet navy to do your cat band and your other two bands on here, so you're not gonna have a bead or a clear jelly. And I've already placed some of the beads down here because, like I said, for some reason my camera decided to shut off, and I'm going to show you how to place them. You're going to place them in all the holes that you don't have a band. Remember, all these bands are across four pins. They need to be on the four pins, not in front of or behind. So I'm going to hold one end of the band and put my hook on the other. And I'm going to place the one end that I have with the hook on, and I'm going to place the other end on. And as you can see, these two don't have the band on yet. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go in, and since the bead's too big to go in between all the way, what you're going to do is you're going to flip it up with your hook. So I'm going to do a couple more of these. I actually may do the rest of them since for some reason my camera decided to shut off. I repel technology. Now, whichever way you feel comfortable with is the way that you should be doing this. If you feel comfortable using two hooks, do it that way. If you feel comfortable using your hands and your fingers, do it that way. Like, instead of holding it with a hook, I can put it on that end and I can pull it with this end. Now, I wouldn't suggest doing that with the band ones because the band will come off on those. These are only staying because the hole in the middle is very small and the band was pulled through that, and it is a tight space in there, and that's why the band's not moving. Oops. All right, so let's see, I have 1, 2, 3, 4 more to go, and I will finish those off camera. And the last thing we're going to do on here is we are going, or the next thing that we're going to do is we are going to place our single chain clear jellies. So I'm going to finish these and be right back. So I finished placing the beads, the periwinkle-like beads, and now I have the two clear jelly single chain bands. So I have them stored on a hook that I don't really use for a hook. I use it as a holding thing. So what I'm going to do is I have the end that's not the capping band end. I'm gonna put it down here. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put it on this third pin bar. I'm gonna put it down there, and I'm gonna put the other one on while I'm down here. Just makes it easier. You're gonna put this one on the fourth pin bar, so they're kind of like right next to each other. And then, like I said before, you're not gonna see these. That's why I use clear, so it would be easier for you not to see. And what you're gonna do is they will not break, trust me. You're gonna pull them down all the way to the other end. Let me get this out of the way, because I don't know. And you're gonna go and grab, since you triple capped it, grab those three parts of it. And you're going to pull it down. And this one is going to go on the fifth pin bar. And this one make sure you have the right bands too is going to go on the second pin bar. Okay, and then while you're looping and everything, you want to make sure that these stay in the middle of those two X's. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna turn it around because we need to add our last couple of bands down here. Get rid of these. And this is gonna be the last bands that we put on the bracelet before we start looping. You need a single sweet navy blue. Remember, you stopped right here at the beginning of the bracelet. Sweet navy blue. Those are both single. Now, you have two sweet navy blues. You're gonna use two of them. But what you wanna do, I want you to stretch them first, okay? And then you're going to twist. You're gonna put them on these two pins to make it tight, okay? So now that is all of our bracelet, all of the beads, the bands, everything is placed. So we are ready to get started on our looping. So the first bands that we are going to loop are going to be the sweets navies. So what I'm gonna do is I am going to zoom in some and I'm gonna show you. You're gonna go in that really thick capping band that you just put on, those two that you doubled, and you're gonna grab that sweet navy. You're gonna pull it over. You're gonna do the same thing to this side. Pull back that capping band, grab the sweet navy, and pull it over. Now you're gonna go in behind the sweet navy. Then whatever band that you have that you used for your X, there's going to be one of those. You need to go in behind it, and you're going to grab that next sweets going. So I'm going to go in behind the sweets navy, and for me, it's the navy medieval I'm going in behind of that X to grab the sweets navy blue, and now you're just going down this whole bracelet with the single chain. And that may happen every once in a while where it pops off of the little peg. That's okay, just put it right back on there. It has to stay on that peg because these are basically like a foundation of the inside of the bracelet to hold together. So you go all the way down that side. You're gonna go all the way down this side in a single chain, making sure that if it comes off, that you put it back on. I'm gonna continue doing this off camera and I will see you here in a second. So I've gone down the full length of the bracelet doing the single chains all the way down, And here I already went in one. I'm going to show you on this side. You're just going to go in once here at the very end. Because what you're going to do is we're going to do this, these two here and the middle one at the very end to close the bracelet up. That's all you're going to do right now. So now we're going to start on the limited edition white pearl or white frosts. And what you're going to do is you're not going to go inside of each of the pegs. You're actually going to go underneath and you're going to grab it with your hook. You're going to flip it over that peg. Okay. The first one's really easy because there is no pegs around it. The second one, you're going to go and grab it and it's going to go around two parts of the other band. You need to make sure that it stays on this side of the peg. Let's do it. You're going to do it on both sides. This is how we get that kind of a little lacy effect on it. So I'm going to finish this up all the way down and I will be right back. So now here's the last one that I did at the very end with a limited edition frost, the white frosts. Now the next band that we are going to loop are going to be the glitter whites. So you're going to go inside of here and go behind the sweet navies, go behind, for me, the medieval blue on the X, and then you're going to grab the glitter white and you're going to pull it back to where the other end of it is so it makes a teardrop. Now you're going to have to look in and make sure that you pull all the bands back because there's a lot of bands, and then pull that next glitter up. Remember, it's a zigzag, so that's what you're going to end up with when you keep pulling them up. So you're going to pull it back, and this time you're going to have this clear crossing band on there, so you need to pull the one you just looped back, the clear crossing band, and then the X, and the other end of that one, and grab it. You're gonna pull everything back. Pull everything back. Make sure you're getting everything, all the bands that you need to pull back so that you see that glitter white. You're gonna do this to both sides. So I'm gonna do this one, and then I'm gonna go over to this side. Go in behind the sweets, the medieval, grab your glitter. Going behind all those bands, grab your glitter. Going behind all of the bands, grab your glitter. Going behind all those bands and grab the glitter. I'm going to keep doing this all the way up the bracelet off camera, and I will show you when we come back. So I've done all the glitter white down to here, and I wanted to say also to be careful when you're looping them and make sure that your limited edition white frost stay on the other side of the pegs and don't flip back over, because if they do, it'll just be like flopping around like a little fish out of water. So all right, here is our next step. Let me scooch on in, and this is the step where we are going to be doing the X's in the middle. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna start, whatever side you started with is usually best to start with when you turn the loom around, because it just keeps a pattern going, or at least for me it does. So I'm gonna start with the left side. So you pull back those sweets and pull the left side up. Now this one you're gonna have to go behind the cat band and behind that single chain clear bands and grab that medieval. Then you're gonna go over here behind the sweets and the single chain and you're just doing the X. And you're going to do this all the way up the loom. Now, remember when you're doing these, you need to pull back the clear cross band each time when you do it, so that the clear cross bands are still in the middle. Oops, I pulled up the other end. See, that's why even we make mistakes. So now I have to find that silver. Pull it up. And if your beads are really big, you might want to push them down a little when you get ready to push or put the bands on. I'm gonna do this one more time, and then I'm gonna go off camera. You're just doing the X's all the way up the loom. So I will be right back. So we've done the X's all the way to the end. And we only have one more step before we can take it off of the loom. All right, so going back to the, going back to the limited edition white frosts, what you're going to do is you're going to pull it in from this second peg when the loom's turned around. You're going to pull it up to that peg right in front of it. You're going to go behind all of the bands and pick up that band right in front and pull it up. You're going to do this all the way up the loom on both sides. I work on this side now. I'm going to grab this one, pull it up. That first one's the easiest. Then you have to go through all of those bands because this one's on the very bottom. What I usually do is I pull back all of the bands, and the first one that snaps back up is usually the first one. All right, so I'm going to continue doing this, and I will come right back. I went all the way up the loom to the very end. As you can see, these last two limited edition white frosts. Now what we're going to do is we are going to go in and grab this sweet navy. You're going to be going through a lot of bands, so it might be helpful to relieve some of the tension. You don't want to force it because they may break. And then you're going to go in here to the ones that there are two of. You're going to pull it over, and I'm going to hold it with my finger. And then you're going to pull the other side over, and I'm going to put both ends on my hook. Grab a C-clip. And I'm going to pull up. All right, So now what we need to do is we need to get it off of the loom. We still have one step after we get it off the loom. What I'm going to do is, you can see the loom's a little wobbly. What we're going to do is we're going to relieve some of the stress off of these bands on the side first. Take them off with your hook. That makes it less likely that they will break when you take them off the loom. I'm just doing it on these outside rows. And then I will show you what we're going to do at the top to get this started to come off the loom. Okay. So what I'm going to do, because I still can't grab the bracelet that easily, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go and I'm going to take the bands all off of that first one. There's a lot of bands on that first one. And off of these. And I'm going to take them off of that next peg. Just so I can get some room to grasp onto the bracelet. When I have that, what I'm going to do is I'm going to very gingerly pull up and it will snap out. I swear you could gain muscle strength by taking some of these bracelets off of the loom. Oh snap. I'm gonna snap myself in the face, I can just tell. Stay. Who needs kettlebell when you have a loom? All right, so here is our bracelet right now, and you can leave your bracelet like this, but what I am going to do, and it looks very frilly and everything on the edges, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to do like they did on the swan bracelet, and we always like to give credit on the swan bracelet. After they took it off of the loom, you needed to slip knot the sides. So what I'm going to do is we are going to do that with the glitters. So this is the back side, this is the front side. What you're going to do is on the back side, you're going to choose the ones that are teardropped, and you're just going to pull those so they're out. The ones that are the teardrops are the ones that you want. And it leaves, it pulls everything that was flowy up front. It just kind of pulls it in. So I'm going to do this to both sides and I will be right back. All right, so here is the bracelet after I have pulled all the little teardrops out from the back side. Make sure you pull them out from the back side. And what you're going to do is you're going to do the slip knot technique on the sides. So what you're going to do is you're going to put your hook through the last band and then put it through the second to the last band. And then you're going to pull that second to last band through the first band. You're going to keep doing that. Make sure you don't miss any. And this is going to give it a little lacy edge. Oops. Just keep going. This is really fast after you start doing it. And by no means am I good at the crocheting or the hook only things where you make I can't say it. But I can do that very well. So I'm wanting, that's like my New Year's resolution, to learn how to do those bears and everything that everyone's able to do. I'm so jealous. All right, so what you're gonna do, I have this one side in my hook, and I'm going to keep my two bands hooked into my C-clip, but I'm gonna take one side out. So it's only hooked on one side now, and I'm going to do the same thing with our closing band. Just gonna put it right back on there. I think I slipped the other one off. Two. All right, so now it's all closed in on there so it won't slip off. I'm gonna do the other side and I will be right back. So here it is on both sides, done. It just gives that little nice little lacy border. And I really love these colors together. Not to toot my own horn, but toot toot. So here it is with the beads, the one that we just did. And here it is before. You can see how it changes how big the diameter is of the bead. It's not as wide. So this one is a little bit longer, just like this first one was, or this one with no beads were. So it's just, it's up to the beads and the bands. I would recommend you do the smaller one versus the whole thing. If you are unsure about the length of your bracelet, this would still fit an average wrist. So it's up to you the way you would like to, the length of the one that you would like to do. And this is our Western Lace Bracelet. If you would like to stay for the one loom version, that's what I'm getting ready to do. But you do not have to if you did it on the 6-pin bars. You do not have to watch the rest. The rest will be all on the one loom. So if you liked this video, would you please comment and give us a big thumbs up down below? If you would like to get emails and notifications about when we have new videos, please subscribe to our channel. We would love that for us to see how many fans that we have. Also, we have our Instagram account that we would love to see your renditions of Western Lace. It is Amandaandmonicarloomy. And if you decide to make the bracelet, if you would hashtag us at Amandaandmonicarloomy and tag us as well so we can see it. We'd love to see everyone's recreations of the bracelets. So everyone have a great day. And for today's tutorial, it's kind of a snowflakey and winter is coming. So anyways, everyone that's going to stay around for the one loom tutorial, come on back. Bye guys that are going to leave us. I totally forgot. We're doing the thing now where we are telling everyone what we are wearing on our wrists, our bracelet. This is Golden Aztec Garden by Miss Adele Griffiths, and it is using the new Silks collection. And this is the Swan Bracelet. Love, love, love it. All right, so if you are with us right now, you have chosen to stay to do the one loom version. And this is the bracelet that we are going to be doing today, our Western lace. This is what I did just a little bit ago with the full loom setup. And this is what we'll be doing here right now. Here is the ones that we did for our mock-up to show our fans and our friends on Instagram for Western lace. And I will show you throughout the tutorial where the bands that we are using in this one, the different colors, where they are in this bracelet, so you know where, what to choose, what colors you should choose. So first off, what I am going to do is I am going to grab some jelly clear bands. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go up. You're going to need to make two of these. And I'm going to go up and make a single chain up this loom. It's just a simple single chain. It's probably the first bracelet that we all learned to make on the loom. Turn it around, and then I'm going to triple cap it. One, two, three. And I'm just going to loop it back. Now for this bracelet, you will be transferring. And it is going to require an extension if you're just using one loom setup. If you're using a double length of a loom, like if you're using two lengths of a loom, it will not need an extension. But if you're just, if you literally just have one loom, it would require an extension. So you should have one like this. You're gonna need two of them. So I'm gonna make another one and I will be right back. So you're gonna need to put these aside for right now, and we're gonna use those a little bit later. Now what we're going to do is we are going to be using the Sweets Navy Blue. And what you're going to do is you're just going to set two on this pin right here. And then you're going to put one, just one, not two. This is, you're only going to have two on this one pin. And you're going to put one right there. We need those at that place because you need to have those at the very bottom so that when you loop the bracelet at the very end, you can have it so that it will all stay together at the very end. Now, for our next band, we have the limited edition pearl or white frost. And on this bracelet, we have used the limited edition gold. Here it is on the back, just to show you what it would look like if you chose to use that color. And what you're going to do is you're going to be making triangles. If you are using a double, if you're using two looms put together end to end at this point, you may want to go back to the start of the tutorial and see where I talk about length of the bracelet, determining where you need to stop on the loom. But for the one loom setup, since you will be using an extension, you do not need that right now. Next, we will be using the glitter white, kind of an iridescent, and you're going to be doing a zigzag. zigzag all the way up the loom. Just gonna push those bands down so that we have room for the next bands that will be placed, which will be our sweet navy blue. The same ones that you placed here, you're gonna continue right here. You're gonna do a single chain down the side of the bracelet. And oh, I forgot to mention, I'm sorry. The glitter white is where we have used the mother of pearl on this bracelet here on the side. Don't really see it too much from the top, but you see it a lot on the sides. And then this sweet navy blue is where we have used the tin man here, right here on the sides. And it's just a little pop of color here on the side. Sorry about that. Go in once. We're not going to go over here just yet because we want to place our next bands first. And these we are going to be doing alternating colors of our medieval navy and silicone silver. And we're going to alternate them each time. So we're going to have medieval blue, navy blue, then silicone silver, medieval blue, silicone silver. I'm going to keep going all the way up the end of the loom and I will be right back. Alright, so now is the time where we are going to do the beading part of the bracelet, where it is, we have the little cute periwinkle glass beads. Now I'm going to show you with a piece of wire that I have that's folded into a V-shaped. I'm going to put one of the clear jellies on there. And you're going to put your bead through the wire. You're going to pull it halfway through. Now, since you're going to be transferring this bracelet, you're going to put, as I throw it down, let's grab another one, a C-clip on one end so it does not pull all the way through when you transfer. That's what it should look like. Now, I will show you, even though we're not going to use it for this part, this tutorial, what you can do if you do not have any beads for this bracelet. What you can do is you can use a couple bands in place of the beads. So what you're going to do is you're going to loop it around your hook three times. So there's one. I'm using the sweets ones. One, two, three. Oops. Those always come off on the third one. All right, so you have two bands on your hook right now. And you're going to pull it through the clear jelly, and you would put a C-clip on one of these ends and then put it on your loom. But since we're not using it for this tutorial, I just wanted to show you that in case you did not have any beads, because some of us don't have any beads, or some of us just don't like to have beads or little charms or doodads on our bracelets, and that's fine. Or you can use the bands, different color bands, a little accent color. So I need to do one more of the periwinkle beads. Let's see. And since these beads are so large in diameter, I'm only doing them every other place on this bracelet, because if I don't, they would get kind of angry with each other and they would hit each other and possibly break. As you can see, there's a little space in between each one of these. So I will show you on this bracelet what you're going to need to do. And if you feel like you're not going to be able to find the other end of the band that does not have a bead on it, what you can do is you can always put a C-clip. I know all of us have tons of C-clips. So what you're going to do is you're going to skip this first one. The next one's going to be the one with a bead. Then what you're going to do is you're going to put it across these two that are parallel to each other. You're going to grab another one, put a C-clip on it. Do the same thing. I'm going to keep doing that up the bracelet, but I wanted to show you the beads. The beads, what you're going to do, because the bead is going to go right here, what you're going to need to do is you're going to put it on two of the pins, just like you did with the one with no bead on it. But as you can see, the beads out here, you need to make sure that those bands go over top of both of those pins. That's very crucial. If not, it could slip out and it could be on top and it could just look like a loose band on your bracelet. So I'm going to continue finishing the rest of this bracelet, adding the bands with nothing on it and the beads, and I will be right back. At this point, your loom should look like this. And now we are going to add one of those single chain clear jelly chains that we made earlier. And what you're going to do is you're going to put the end that you have to hold together that's not being held by the cat band on this first pin bar. And you're going to use your hook to grab all three of those pieces of that one band that you triple capped. You're going to pull it down, and you're going to put it, the end of it, on the second pin bar. I lost one of the ends. Let me get it. Why is it always going to be so difficult? Really? Seriously. Okay, there we go. I don't even think that's the one that... No, that's not it. Really. Alright, you know it's probably the easiest? If I take it all off and just grab it again. Okay. Make sure all three of them get on there. Stay. Good job, Monica. Yes, we have to encourage ourselves sometimes. All right, so at the end, the other end where you're getting ready to close it off, what you're going to do is you're going to put one sweet band, and then you're going to have two sweet bands, but you're going to stretch them. You're going to double it, put a cat band through it, or put a C-clip on it so that you won't lose it. And now we are ready to loom this side of our bracelet. All right. So what you're going to do is you're going to pull that cat band back. And you're going to go and grab that band, that sweet band that you just put behind it. Underneath it, not behind it. And take it back so it makes a teardrop. I'm just pulling the C-clip over. And then you're going to go in behind that sweets and behind whatever band you used for the X and grab the sweets And we are just looming out the navy sweets single chain on the sides. And you need to do this first because it's like a foundation of the bracelet to help everything hold it together. Kind of like a dress or whatever, an outfit, a garment. You need the foundations to hold everything together. Just gonna keep this on video because it will go so fast. All right, and did you see how this one kind of popped off of that? You need to bring both of those back over, because if not, it will not be good. All right, so this part of the video, you're gonna go in and you're going to, let me zoom in a little. You're gonna go in underneath, you're not gonna go through the pin, you're gonna go in underneath and grab that limited edition white frost, and you're gonna pull it over top of that one pin. On each of them. Wherever the point was is where you're gonna pull that pin or that band over and pull it over the pin. All right. So now our next step is we're gonna go in and we are gonna do the zigzag glitter white. So you need to go in behind the sweets, behind whatever color you did the X, and grab the glitter. And you're just making sure you pull back everything that you need to pull back to get to that glitter. You don't want to go in front of bands. You need to go and make sure there's nothing in front of that glitter. So I'm going to keep doing this and I will be right back. So I went all the way up here with the glitter white. Now we are ready to do the X, all of the X's. So whatever side you started with at the beginning, whether you start on the left or the right, you need to start with that side down here. So I'm going to go in behind those sweets and grab the band. For me, it's silver. I'm going to go in behind that cap, behind the cap band, and behind the clear jelly single chain. And then I'm going to go in behind here, making sure you go in behind that clear band with either the bead on it or by itself. You want to make sure that you go in behind it. Do this one more time. I'm going to go off camera. All right, so I'm gonna continue doing this to the very end. The X's have been loomed out to the very end here, and there's one more step before we pull it off of the loom. You're gonna go down here to the very end, and you're gonna grab the limited edition white frost. You're gonna take it to the pin above it. Then you're gonna go in everyone and do that. What helps me is I go and I pull all the bands back, and usually the first band that snaps back is the limited edition pearl, because they were the first bands that you put on there. And you're just pulling them up to the next pin, kind of like you're doing a single chain, but remember the rest of that band has been looped over here. All right, So now we're going to go in, and you're going to have to relieve some tension probably because there's a lot of bands on this one pin. And grab that sweets band from the very bottom. I'm just relieving some of the tension right there. And then you're going to go, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab my holding hook, and I'm going to grab it. And what you're going to do is you're going to grab those two sweet spans that are together, put them both on one end, or both ends on the hook, or whatever you have your other single chain clear jellies on. So now we are completely done with this bracelet on this side on the loom. Now I'm just going to relieve some tension so we can take it off of the loom, and we can do the next part. Okay. So still holding on. I always like to hold on to this just in case. I don't like to let it go. And especially this one, since there's so many bands on that first. Now you should be able to very gingerly pull it off of the loom. So here is the bracelet for right now. Now remember, we have to do the other end of it. Oops, and I lost that. Okay, and there is one extra step at the end that you need to do after we've hooked the other side on. So with our looms, this is how it was for this side of the bracelet. Now we are getting ready to do the opposite side. So we need to change the position of the bracelet. Let me zoom it. We're gonna change the position of the bracelet. Oh, not the bracelet, the loom. So now that the one pin bar is up on this side. Now, you're going to do everything exactly the same, but mirrored on this side. Except you don't have to add the two bands here at the very beginning. You don't have to add that. What you're going to do is you're going to make sure that you know which side is the top. Now, I will tell you that the bands that are doubled, the limited edition frost bands that are doubled, those are the ones that go on the back side, okay? So what you're gonna do is this is going to go just like so. So I'm still holding the other end of it with my holding hook. But as you can see, the bracelet now has the doubled limited edition bands on top here. Okay? That's what you want to see on top, because this is the back of the bracelet actually. So now we can go ahead, and you're going to do the exact same thing on here. So I'm going to do all of it off camera, and then I'll show you how to add at the very, all the beads back on before you start looming. So I'll be right back. All right, so everything is exactly the same as it was on the other side as on this side, but it's just mirrored. So this side has all of the triangles and everything, and this side has all of the X's. So now what we are going to do is we are going to add on the bands with nothing on them and the bands with the beads right now that we have put a C-clip on so that they do not fall off. So what I'm gonna do is you skip this first one, and you're just gonna pull the band that has the C-clip part on it over those two pins. So that's what I did. So I'm going to take the C-clip off now. It shouldn't be too hard to come off. And then you're going to grab the next one, which is the band with nothing on it but the C-clip. You're going to pull it up and over those two. And I just noticed that I put the single chain before I put these on, which that's fine. It doesn't matter if it's on before or after. You just need to have it on to get a little more cushion in there. So I'm going to continue doing this and I will be right back after I get the C-clip off. Alright, now I will be right back. Alright, so this looks really funny, but it's how much this bracelet actually shrinks up. So I wanted to show you that they're all of them are on the correct places. They're just kind of shrunk down some. Now what we have is our C-clip on our doubled bands that were turned into a cat band. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pull it down here. I'm going to put it over top of that last pin. And I'm going to take the C-clip off because we will not need a C-clip down there. I'm going to try and get the C-clip off. Maybe before. You definitely need the C-clip because if not, this one will just kind of shrivel up into nothing. Alright. There. So I'm going to go off camera and I'm actually going to loom all of this bracelet out, because if you watch the video again, it's the exact same process through all of this. And I will come back and I will show you how to close this off, and then we will work on an extension. So I will come back and this will be pretty much loomed out. Alright, so I have loomed the bracelet all the way up to where you need to move the sweets, this last sweet band. And then what you have is your cat band still. So I'm going to go in behind the sweets, grab the cat band, and I'm actually going to slide both ends of that cat band. Not cat band, the band at the end to put the C-clip on, onto the one hook, and then grab the C-clip. Put it on one side and then onto the other. Okay. So now that should make the bracelet secure. I'm going to go and I'm going to release some of the tension here on the side. Bands on it, and then very gingerly I'm going to remove the bracelet. Okay, so here is our bracelet. We will be making an extension for it, but what we need to do is you can leave it like this. It's nice and flowy on the sides, but what we are going to do is we are going to do a little bit of the technique that was used on the swan bracelet by pulling, this is the back side because you have the two limited edition frosts, What you're going to do is you are going to pull on the back side these little teardrops. You're going to pull those out on both sides, or on both this side and this side. So I'll show you what it does on the front when you pull it out. I'm making sure I'm pulling the right one out. It just kind of makes everything come in a little tighter, and it really showcases the sweets bands. Then on the side, when you do it this way. Like I said, you don't have to do this. This is just an option. Let's see. This is just an option for you to do it a little differently on the edges, so it's a little tighter. So when I pulled the wrong one. Okay. So now what you're going to do is you're going to start here at the end with the cat band, and you are going to go in at that very first band, and you're going to put that second band on. You're going to slip it through and do it again all the way down. And this is going to be the ending portion of the bracelet. We are still going to do an extension. It's going to be a doubled extension, or a double row extension instead of just a single row, because this is a wider bracelet. All right, so what you're going to do now is you're going to take your hook and grab one end off of those two bands of the C-clip and pull it through, and then put it back on the C-clip. That way those glitter whites are nice and secure. And you're gonna do the same thing on this side. This side's just not as easy for me, being a lefty. Just keep pulling them through. You can go as fast or as slow as you want. I know I'm not very good at the hook only designs. I'm getting better. But my New Year's resolution is to work on those how to make like the really cool bears, and that one girl made that huge Garfield. So amazing. Alright, so I just pulled off the one end off of the C-clip, and you're going to pull it through. Oops, I think I lost one of those. No, I didn't. Yes, I did. Okay, make sure you have both of those sweet bands, and then you pull both of them through. Put it back on the C-clip. Alright, so here is the bracelet. Now we're going to work on extension. We already have our loom set up like this. So what we're going to use is the medieval navy and the silver silicone. And we're going to do double bands. And we're just going to keep that same pattern that we had on the middle rows on here. So I'm going to have two medieval navies and two silver silicones, and we're going to go all the way up this one loom. So I'll be right back. Okay, so I just went all the way to the end of the loom with the doubled silicone silver and the medieval navy. Now I've already started doing the cross bands, and all I'm doing is using the clear jelly, and I am just that went really far someplace in this room. I'm just capping them. I'm putting them over two pegs. You're not gonna put these over the first two pins, these two pins, or these last two pins, but they should be over the rest of them. And then what you're gonna do is you're gonna go in and you see your cat band on your bracelet down here. You're gonna go in and you're gonna use that as the cat band for your extension. Make sure they're all on there. And you're just gonna start looming it out. Alright, make sure that you go in behind the clears. One that time. Where are you? There you are. All right. So I'm going to take the rest of this bracelet off of the loom. I'm actually going to just put these on my hook for right now, and then you can fit it on there later differently. But then there is your cap or your extension to your bracelet, and I think that's a very cute extension myself, if I do say so myself. So here is the, and you may have to stretch it some too. Here is the one loomed version of our Western Lace bracelet. And I hope you all enjoyed it. We do try and accommodate everyone that just has one loom or two looms, because we know not everyone can have like four or five looms, or I'm not mentioning how many looms Amanda and I have, but we want everyone to be able to make these larger bracelets, so we always like to try and make new designs that anyone can make with their looms. So I hope that everyone likes this bracelet idea, and I wanted to show you all how you could close this bracelet off. You can just pull two bands through all of those bands, and then you can put it down here on the C-clip. So this is our tutorial for Western Lace. If you liked it, please hit the like button down below. If you would like to get notifications or emails about new tutorials coming up, please subscribe to our channel and comment down below about maybe anything you'd like to see coming up, maybe color patterns you would like us to use. We're always looking for new ideas that way. Also our Instagram, if you choose to make this design of ours, if you will hashtag us at hashtag AmandaandMonicarloomy and then tag us so we will be able to see it. We love everyone that subscribes to us and follows us on Instagram. You all are true friends and have become our looming family. Thank you all so much. Have a great day. Bye.